Hi everyone, welcome again to this English course presented by Ahmed Sayar, an English high school teacher in Sheikh Mekki Nasseri in Tetouan, Morocco. This course is intended to second year back students working with Ticket to English textbook, Unit Number 3, Formal, Informal, and Non-Formal Education. Alright, the content. In this video, we are going to study function and grammar in Unit Number 3. Alright, let's start then. Function, today we are going to study expressing purpose. Good. Expressing purpose. تعبير عن الهدف. الغاية. Expressing purpose. Alright, let's start then. Notice and study the following sentences. The journalist met Mr. Zhang to interview him. The journalist met Mr. Zhang for an interview. This means that we need to double our efforts and our investments in order to achieve the same results. This means that we need to double our efforts and our investments so as to achieve the same results. This means that we need to double our efforts and our investments so that we can achieve the same results. Posters and brochures are used to convince people to study. Posters and brochures are used for convincing people to study. Pay attention here. So, what type of WH question do most of the previous sentences answer? So let's go back again. The journalist met Mr. Zhang to interview him. What is the question here that the word to interview answers? Why? Very good. Why? Why did the journalist meet Mr. Zhang? Why? And the answer? To interview him or because he wanted to interview him. Good. Complete the following chart with examples of expressing purpose. Of course, from this text we have to plus infinitive to interview. Good. For plus noun. An example in this text we have for an interview. For plus ing for convincing. In order to plus infinitive in order to achieve. So that plus modal. Pay attention here. With so that we always use the modal. So that we can achieve. So as to plus infinitive. So as to achieve. Good. So these are the examples we have in the text. Okay. In Arabic we say لكي. Okay. أو من أجلي. لكي أو من أجلي. For an interview, من أجل حوار أو مقابلة. To interview, لكي يحاور. Good. In order to, the same thing, لكي. Alright, let's move on. Practice now. Match a sentence from A with a sentence from B to make a new one. Vary your structures. Now first, let's match the sentences in A with sentences in B. First sentence, our government opened new schools. Why? Ask the question why. Why did our government open new schools? Good, so the answer is going to be they wanted to encourage more children to attend school. Good. Now, let's use this in a sentence expressing purpose. Okay? Pay attention. This is how we are going to do, okay? Now look at the example. Our government opened new schools so as to encourage more children to attend school. لكي يشجع. So as to encourage, okay? Now pay attention here. We deleted they wanted to and put in place so as to. So here we express purpose. When you see so as to, in order to, or to, it, or so that, or so that, or for, it's expressing purpose. Good. Let's move to the next sentence now. They use the media. Why? They want to sensitize people to the advantages of literacy. Sensitize تحسيس to the advantages of literacy. The أهمية القراءة. Literacy. Good. Now let's make it in a sentence. Pay attention. They use the media so that they can sensitize people to the advantages of literacy. Of course, I can change. ممكن بدل. Instead of so that they can, ممكن استعمل in order to. They use the media in order to sensitize people. Or they use the media to sensitize the people. But if I want to use for, and I would استعمل for, استعمل ing with the verb for sensitizing people. Good. Let's move to the next one. They make a great effort. Why? They make a great effort. Why? The answer is going to be they want to reduce illiteracy rates. To reduce بمعنى تقليص illiteracy rates بمعنى معدل الأمية. They want to reduce. Now let's make it in a sentence. They make a great effort to reduce illiteracy rates or in order to reduce or so as to reduce. لابغينا نستعملو so that نعملو so that they can reduce. Okay, so that is always with models. Great, let's move on now. Radio and television are also used. Why? So the answer is going to be they wanted to reach more people everywhere in the country. Radio and television are used. They wanted to reach because they wanted to reach people everywhere in the country, to reach بمعنى ليصلوا إلى. Now make it in a sentence. Radio and television are used for reaching people everywhere in the country. Now pay attention here. استعملنا for. The verb is in ing. We can say in order to reach, so as to reach, so that they can reach. Very good. Let's move on. Adults go to literacy classes. Why? Why? They want to learn how to read and write. Literacy classes بمعنى دروس ولا أقسام لنحو الأمية أو لتعلم القراءة. They want to learn. Now make it in sentence. Adults go to literacy classes so that they can learn how to read and write. Or in order to learn. Or so as to learn. So these are the expressions we use to express purpose. Okay? عبارات اللي كنستعملو اللي كنبغيو نعبرو على التعبير عن الهدف أو الغاية من شيء معين. All right, let's move on now. Now we move to grammar. The past perfect. Now, read the following sentences and underline the events which happened first. Underline. تسطروا على الأحداث اللي وقعت هي الأولية في التسلسل الكرونولوجي ديال الأحداث. شكون الحدث اللي وقع في الأول وجا من مراه حدث آخر. Okay, so look at the first sentence. After my aunt had done a lot of housework yesterday, she went to her literacy classes. Here we have two events. And you should add it in here. Done a lot of housework, went to literacy classes. إذن أنا done, went. Which one happened first? كل حدث اللي وقع الأول في التسلسل. Yes. This is the first one. Good. So this is the first event. B. Which event happened first? Yes. Had learned her lessons. Good. C. Which event happened first? Very good. She had never been so motivated. All right. And D. Good. She had been working. Very good. E. Very good. She had made great efforts. All right. F. Had studied. Very good. All right. لاحظوا ملاحظة مهمة هنا. أحداث اللي سطرنا عليها واللي وقعت هي الأولية دائما كنلقاو فيها ديك had done had learned had never been had been working had made great effort had studied. It's very important. الملاحظة مهمة بزاف. أننا نلقاو دائما الحدث اللي كيوقع الأول دائما كيكون فيه had. وغنقول لكم علاش من بعد. Good. Let's move on. Now, reread the sentences above to fill in the following table these sentences هاد الجمل اللي شفنا دابا هاد. Now غنحاولوا نستعملوهم هنايا. Which one? Simple past. Examples of simple past and example of past perfect simple and continuous. هنا عندنا مثال. Went is simple past. Had done, had been doing is past perfect. Okay. Examples of went. We have met, told, benefited, felt, and got. Examples of past perfect simple or continuous. Had learned, had never been, had been working, had made, had studied. Very good. Let's move on. Support the following uses of past perfect with examples from the sentences above. شمال السؤال. So, had A, B, C, D. These are uses. استعمالات ديال the past perfect. لأن احنا دابا كنقراو past perfect. Okay? هنا فيك استعملوا past perfect. With examples from the sentences above. يعني الجمل اللي شفنا قبل غنحاولوا نستعملوا نطبقوا عليهم هذه القاعدة. قاعدة رقم واحد. First rule, the past perfect is used to show that one event happened before another. كنستعملوا past perfect باش كنبينوا لأن واحد الحدث حدث قبل حدث آخر. Yes, نعطيكم مثال. Good, these are the examples. After my aunt had done a lot of housework yesterday, she went to her literacy classes. هذه الجملة كتبين لنا شنو الأحداث. واحد الحدث وقع قبل الآخر. شنو هو اللي وقع قبل الآخر؟ My aunt had done a lot of housework. عملت قامت بالأشغال ديال البيت. والحدث اللي جا موراه she went to her literacy classes. من بعد مشات الدروس ديال المعهد الأمية. إذن شنو هو الحدث اللي وقع الأول؟ هو doing a lot of housework. الحدث الثاني going to the literacy classes. إذن دائما الحدث الأول كنستعمل معه past perfect. She had never been so motivated before. She benefited from this program. إذن عندنا benefited from this program. This is the last event. هذا آخر حدث وقع قبل بالنوة. She had never been motivated. قبل ما تستفد من هذا البرنامج عمرها ما كانت متحمسة. She had never been motivated. Last month she got a prize from the association. حصلت على جائزة من الجمعية. علاش؟ Because she had made. حصلت على جائزة لأن قبل منها قامت بمجهود جبار. Great efforts. لاحظتوا؟ دائما الحدث الأول اللي كيكون وقع في الماضي كتكلموا على past. دائما الحدث الأول كيكون ب past perfect. Good. Next one. The past perfect is used to show cause and effect. Yes. One example is this. She felt tired. Why? شعرت بالتعب. علاش؟ Because she had been working a lot all the week. أسبوع كامل وهي خدامة. يعني قبل ما تشعر بالتعب قبل منها كانت خدمت أسبوع كامل. الحدث الأول أعطانا النتيجة ديالو. الحدث الثاني. Okay. Cause and effect. Good. The past perfect is used in reported speech. Yes. ومن بعد غادي نقراو reported speech اللي كنلقاو فيه told. When she met Nadia, then she told her she had learned her lessons. هذا غادي نقراوها إن شاء الله في الدروس اللي مجال ديال report speech. The past perfect is used to show that something started in the past and continued up until another action in the past. بمعنى حدث وقع في الماضي واستمر في الحدوث إلى غاية حدوث أو وقوع حدث آخر في الماضي. نشوفوا المثال اللي عندنا هنايا. نادية had studied for 10 years. إذا نادية قرات لمدة 10 سنوات before she got married. قبل ما تزوج. إذا قبل ما تزوج قرات لمدة 10 سنوات. الحدث ديال القراءة انتهى في اللحظة اللي تزوجت فيها. Okay? So this long action happening in the past. وقعت في الماضي ومراها جاء حدث آخر وقع في الماضي. Very good. Now let's move now to something else. دابا غادي نشوفوا القاعدة ديال the past perfect. So in the past perfect we have the past perfect simple. Now the past perfect simple شنو هو form of شكل ديالو had plus verb in past participle. Good. شنو معنى ديال past participle؟ Past participle هي الخانة اللي كنلقاو فيها لائحة الأفعال. كنلقاو ثلاثة الخانات. الخانة الأولى والثانية والثالثة. الخانة الثالثة هي past participle. بحال مثلا go كنعملو went gun. Okay. The gun هذيك هي past participle. For other verbs, أفعال عند ED, simple past و past participle. Now look at the example. Had studied, that's the verb to study. Had gone, that's the verb to go. Pay attention, with had, كنستعملوها مع I, you, he, she, it, we, they. It's no problem. Then do we have the past perfect continuous. بدل لا, past perfect continuous. Then we have two kinds of past perfect. جوج أنواع, simple and continuous. The form of the continuous is this. Had been plus verb ing. إذن كيكون عندنا had been وعاد كنعملو الفعل. Example. Had been working. فين هو الفعل هنايا؟ Where is the verb? Work. To work is the verb. Okay? نصرف في past perfect continuous. في الجملة اللي قبل to study is the verb. نصرف في past perfect simple. Another example. Had been driving. Had been driving. Good. Negative past perfect كنستعملو دائما hadn't. They hadn't found the house when they arrived. They hadn't found the house when they arrived. Negative hadn't. Interrogative had plus subject plus verb plus participle. Had they done the homework before they came? Before they came قبل ما يجيو. Had they done the homework? واش عملو قبل ما يجيو الحدث اللي وقع قبل منه واش عملو التمرين ديالهم. Had they done the homework? Good. More examples, more practice, and more rules. So, قاعدة نزيدو نشرحو في past perfect. The past perfect simple is used to clarify the order of two past actions. إذن باش نبينو ترتيب ديال جوج الأحداث. The first action uses the past perfect. The second action uses the past simple past. إذن دائما الحدث اللي وقع الأول كنستعملو فيه past perfect. To state that an action which occurred in the past was completed before the second action in the past started. بحال المثال اللي كنت عطيتكم قبل she had studied for 10 years before she got married. Example number 3. I was very tired when my friend came to pick me up. I had worked all the day. كنستعملوها في report speech, كنستعملوها في conditional type 3 باقي عاد غنشوفوا هاد الدروس, وكنستعملوها في رقم 5 to express past wish. هاد الدروس باقي عاد غادي نشوفوه. فرق ما بين past perfect simple and past perfect continuous, ما كاينش فرق الا انني كنبغي نركز على طول ديال الحدث. اوكي, طول ديال الحدث يعني الحدث كان طويل. Example, before he retired he had been doing a lot of business in many countries. هنا ركزت على الحدث كان طويل, took a lot of time. Good, let's move on now. Practice. Put the verbs between brackets in the past, simple or perfect. نتابعو معايا مزيان. حنا خصنا نعملو إما في past perfect ولا past. Okay, first sentence. Nadia never read such an interesting story before she moved to university in Spain. تابعو معايا مزيان. هنا عندها ديجا عندها past. She moved. إذا هنا غادي نعمل وعندنا never. لاحظوا لأن past perfect دائما كنستعملو مع never مع ever. كنستعملو مع past
perfect بمعنى
في الجملة الأولى غادي had never read. Nadia had never read such an interesting story before she moved to university in Spain. B. The sentence is interrogative. نتابعو معايا مزيان الجملة هنايا سؤال. وهنا عندنا عاود moved. ديجا عندنا simple past راهو moved. إذا خصني نعمل هنايا past perfect. غادي الجملة had Nadia ever studied. Had Nadia ever studied. Sentence C. She be there once as a tourist. هنا عندنا one verb. نستعملو بطبيعة الحال simple past. She was there once. ملي يكون عندكم once simple past. D. She only understood the text in Spanish because she understood. ديجا عندي في simple past. إذا هنا غنعمل past perfect. Had read. E. She get a good mark because she had revised well before. عندنا هنا had revised. إذا خصني نستعمل simple past. مايمكنش نستعمل جوج ديال past perfect. Yes. She got a good mark. She have a part-time job for 2 years before she finished her studies. تابعو معايا هنايا عملت for 2 years. إذا الجواب هنايا غنعمل had. كاين بزاف ديال الكلام اللي غنسقسهم كيفاش had. ما فهمناش هاد. Yes, had. علاش هذا؟ هاد الاوليه خاصه بالباس بيرفكت، لان الباس بيرفكت قلنا كيتكون من هاد زائد فيرب باس بارتيسيبل. هاد الثانيه ديال الفيرب، شمن فيرب؟ تو هاف. باس بارتيسيبل ديال الفيرب تو هاف هي هاد، غيكون جواب شي هاد هاد ا بارت تايم جوب فور 2 ييرز بيفور شي فينيش هير ستاديز. و الجمله الثالثه شي read a novel for 10 continuous hours when she went to bed. هنا جواب صحيح she had been reading، او لا ممكن نعملو she read، ولكن شنو الفرق؟ علاش عملت هنايا she had been reading؟ why؟ now because لاحظوا في الجملة for 10 continuous hours بمعنى لمدة 10 ساعات متتالية. اذا هنا علاش كنركز ملي كنقول لمدة 10 ساعات متتالية؟ راه كنبغي نبين على ان راه كانت طويلة العملية، وهنا خصنا نعبر باستعمال past perfect continuous. بحال اللي كتقول لشي واحد وليلة كاملة وانا خدام. الفرق ما بين ليلة كاملة وانا خدام وما بين خدمت في الليل، خدمت وليلة كاملة وانا خدام، كنبغي نبين على ان it was a long action. Alright, let's move on. We got in the classroom, the teacher started the lesson. Now استعملوا after and before، تابعوا معايا في قاعدة مزيان. After is always followed by past perfect. Before is followed by simple past. نبداو بالجملة الأولى. زهرة finished her homework. She went to bed. Okay, so شكون الحدث اللي وقع الأول وشكون الحدث اللي وقع الثاني؟ لأن الحدث اللي وقع الأول هو اللي غنستعمل معاه past perfect. واش finished her work؟ عاد مشات نعس أو لا مشات نعس عاد كملت؟ شوف هنا خصني نحدد مزيان. So finished her work is the first. هذه الجملة. Zahra had finished her work, then she moved, she went to bed. Once I'm after and before, غادي الجملة بهذه الطريقة. After Zahra had finished her homework, she went to bed. Before she went to bed, Zahra had finished her homework. Good. Let's move now. Her father turned off the TV. She finished watching a program about non-formal education. Which one happened first? Yes. الحدث اللي وقع الاول هو انا finished watching، تكملت كتفرج في البرنامج، عاد الاب ديالها طفى turned off، طفات التلفاز. اذا finished هي اللي غنستعملها في الباست بيرفكت. غادي الجمله بهذه الطريقه. After she had finished watching a program about non-formal education, her father turned off the TV. Or before her father turned off the TV, she had finished watching a program about non-formal education. Good. Next one. Zahra started to revise her lessons at 5:30. At 6, her friends Nadia knocked at the door. وحنا باين شكون الحدث اللي وقع الاول، اذا غادي نعملو في past perfect. غادي الجمله after Zahra had started to revise her lessons, her friend Nadia knocked at the door. Or before her friend Nadia knocked at the door, Zahra had started to revise her lessons. Good. Next one. Zahra set up a small enterprise. She became an educated woman. Set up بمعنى أسست. أسست enterprise بمعنى مقاولة. She became an educated. أصبحت امرأة مثقفة أو لا متعلمة. إذا شكون اللي وقع الأول هنا؟ نحددو شكون الحدث اللي وقع الأول. واش حتى فتحت مقاولة عاد ولات متعلمة أو حتى ولات متعلمة عاد فتحت مقاولة؟ يس. الجملة غادي بهذه الطريقة. هذه after she had become an educated woman, Zahra set up a small enterprise. Or before Zahra set up a small enterprise, she had become an educated woman. Good. Next one. Many illiterate people got enrolled. Got enrolled بمعنى يتسجلوا. تسجل. Illiterate بمعنى الناس اللي ما قارينش أميين. The Ministry of Education launched. Launch بمعنى هي أطلقت برنامج literacy بروغرام، بمعنى أطلقت برنامج لمحو الأمية. إذا هنايا شكون اللي وقع؟ شكون اللي حدث الأول؟ واش الوزارة طلقت البرنامج عاد تسجلوا الناس، ولا حتى تسجلوا الناس عاد طلقت البرنامج؟ دونك خصنا نحددوا هنا شكون باش نشوفوا فين غنستعملوا the past perfect. So the sentence is going to be like this. After the Ministry of Education had launched a literacy program, many illiterate people got enrolled. Or before many illiterate people got enrolled, the Ministry of Education had launched a literacy program. Good. Very good. Now let's move on. So for more exercises, please go to Agenda Web. .org verbs, right past perfect exercises, and you are going to find many, many, many exercises online, please, just to practice more. Thank you for watching. This is the end of Function and Grammar, Unit Number 3, presented by Ahmed Sayar. See you later, and before you leave, remember to like, share, follow, and subscribe just for other people to benefit from this video. فقط للتلاميذ الآخرين باش يستفدوا من هذا الفيديو. Thank you very much. See you next time in the next video. Hi everyone, welcome again to this English course presented by Ahmed Sayar, an English high school teacher in Sheikh Mekki Nasseri in Tetouan, Morocco.